Folks, look, I sharp trades. A mixed day on Wall Street. In fact, part of the day was negative when price rolled over very hard in the midday, first part of the morning, and then down into the lunch hour. Made a reversal of the 310 support and then it went up. Closing below the resistance at 315. This is a strong resistance, stubborn. The lower shadow though indicates buying. So let's see if he extends. What I don't like is his dumbbell volume picked up. If tomorrow he opens lower and dumbbell volume increases, this will go lower. We'll go to 306, 308. This is primary support. And then down here, the moving averages, if that's the case. There was a large. Was a report today of bankruptcies starting to creep in in the economy. So this is a sign that people are struggling and let's pay attention to the signs. The VIX today popped. Was a brief day trade, UVXY, when it was here inside the through this consolidation again, the early part of the morning, and then 33 was the resistance, and the price reversed. So it closed the VIX, it closed down, so the fear went back into the box. But if it moves above the moving averages, especially above this set of highs near 39, then it could go higher and we'll have a problem. But that has to show up in the market as well. All right, so let's take a look at the individual stocks. We have some new ideas as well. I always like to introduce new things. I don't always have to have a chance to catch everything or trade everything or overwhelm you with massive amount of messages. That's not the place. But in case you trade several things, here are your ideas. So starting with ABT. ABT was mentioned multiple times. I like this pendant formation for wedge, more like a wedge. And it's attempting a breakout. It's above the moving averages, it's moving sideways. The support here is 90 and 85. If this is the breakout, needs more volume to confirm, but I'm looking for 98. 98, 105, and 115. ALT was mentioned a few days ago here as a potential for a swing. This is not in the list, but was mentioned yesterday, big move, even within the day trading, and today extended up to my target at 24, huge volume. It could get higher, 29, 34, and 41. But any pullback, this thing moves fast, so just be careful, your support is 15. Arrowhead consolidation, number volume picked up a little bit. This stay long as long as it remains above the ATMA. The support is now 44 and 43. No, 44.50 and 43. Targets are 47 and 50. AYRO, this was a brief day trade. The day trades today did not shine at all. And this one popped, rallied a little bit, and then went down very hard. So nothing else to do with this one. Just since we are in the topic of day trading, these are the one we cover today. Arrowhead and the BLDP, which worked a little bit early morning, and then CEMI, CAMI, looks interesting, and LCA in case you ended up trading it. But again, very mixed and underperforming day with regards to the day trading. And so this is one of them, forget about it. Oops. AZN made a pop today, came as high as 55, and then a pullback. There was a call order flow large yesterday, and today didn't make much of a move, not much of a move, but it needs to come above 55 to make the next leg up. Looking for 36.30. 56.30, 58, 98, and 61. Support 53 and 52. This is another of those day trade that didn't work. With the popular consolidation support, it was 310 and 2 and 290 broke. BLDP made a move today, and this looks like want to go higher. As a day trade also made a an attempt run in the beginning with this pendant consolidation, and then he needed to break to the upside. Instead, he broke to the downside with upper volume, and then he went down. Got a bounce off the support at 1975. Oops. So let's see. 1975. It looks still very strong. As, you know, the electric, this is the one of the electric topics sector that is going on in this phase. I want to extend. I'm looking for 22, 2360, and 25. Support is 1975, and then the ATMA down at 1841 if you are trading it. First sell continues. I like the look of this chart a lot. Take him down, test 281, held the support, got a bounce, hit 280. That's 278. Primary support is 280 and then 260. This is a resistance, 307. It's pressing. There was a large volume today. I sent you a message. Maybe not. Maybe I just saw it. Anyway, 400. That's significant, 400,000. I'm looking for 336, second target, and 405, third target, in support again, 280 and 260. FII, this was mentioned in the training room for day traders. Big volume right here. I posted when it was near 1250. Didn't make much of a move. This is the catalyst for the next one moving forward. Next move moving forward. Let's see what comes out of this one. Let's see. We got. I'm looking for 1380, 1472, and maybe 1546. The support is the 50 simple moving average at 12. Glue, this is a new one, broke out or is attempting a breakout. The volume is good, large call option flow. There is a resistance that needs to take out is 1072. Targets are 1175, 1320, and 1479. Support, we have 10 and 950, the 50 simple moving average area. Myrna, is coming back. I sent you a message. This is a new one also. Big pop, huge volume, a consolidation pop. It didn't made a move as a day trading, but looks very enticing, interesting. Positive news, partner up with Roche, one of those pharmaceutical companies. Positive news, well received by the market. And volume is big, crossing the OBV and the moving average down here in the volume area. I'm looking for 67, this is the first target, above that 71 and 77. These companies are a little pain in the neck, so be careful because it moves fast. And the support are both tight, 62 and 60, 50 simple the moving average. Marvel, this is a follow-up from yesterday. Again, mentioned the trading room for day traders, covered yesterday in the trades of the day video. Making a move as well. Volume needs to be, volume is steady. With more, this will fly. 39, 42, and 44. I think is an all-time high breakout. Let's see. Okay, support today low 37 and then the 80 mail down at 36. Invicta continues to trend. So if you are trading this one, trade the channel as long as it remains above this channel and the 80 mail important, then this is long. Today a little bit of a profit taking possibly with support at 32.60. This area is your primary support, secondary support on the channel bottom near 31. Looking for if he extends 37 and 40. An analyst again gave a target of 35, so we're right there. Paula made a move today and might have attempted the breakout, but we don't have the volume quite yet. As you can see, it's the same size as yesterday. 3.6 today, 3.6 yesterday. So it's still consolidating, but the intraday action was very bullish with this pop to 366 and then a pullback. It didn't extend. there was another Dunbar volume, another large volume here, and that's why we saw this little bit of a reversal pullback. And bottom line is that for me, three needs to hold. Three and the ATMA. So we might have this kind of scenario right now. The pendant is extending, something like that. And yeah, let's see when we get a pop, if we get a pop. I'm looking for four and five. How about that 620? Roku, this is a new one. It's already working, a nice action, a large call option flow. And giving an entry when it was near 143, that was the entry opportunity. Here dropped all the way down to 140, and exactly 139.61. Can't remember exactly what the stops were, but 140 and 130, 140 and 130. Anyway, this very strong, big move coming off of this double resistance here, and then this lateral resistance, so triple breakout. 153, this is my first target, 174 and 204. We might even see 240 if he gets to the channel bottom at some point. Support item now, 143 and 135. Solo, still quiet. Technicals are still bullish. We are at the moment even, entry 490, we're right there for 83, 481. It's okay, what I wanna see is a lower opening tomorrow and a move below, first of all, today high, 450, that's primary support, and then yesterday high, 438. So for us, primary and secondary support is 450 and 4. But again, those areas need to hold. I'm looking for a break and hold above 510. Targets are 6 and 750. SPAQ, this is another one that was spotted and posted in the day in the trading room for the day traders. When this thing comes up. Okay, there it goes. Pop, massive volume consolidation, pennant rolled over a little bit and then broke out of this trend line of the pennant. Didn't have a lot of volume, but extended to 14.78 in the after hour market is up a little bit, possibly 16, 17, 18, 20 was the next target, if you extend. This is in the electrical sector, but very volatile, came off of very few shares here. Actually, no, what am I talking about? Lots of shares today, just huge, 37 million shares, sorry, I got confused. Oh my gosh, I didn't notice. Yeah, I mean, okay, so some days not much, and then other days normal. Okay, so today massive move. Anyway, this, if it extends, those are your targets. And if it pulls back 13.70, and half of this candle will be 12.50. Space is flying. Beautiful, yesterday we spotted this couple of large volume orders and a message that was the catalyst for the next move, and it came. It came faster. I didn't expect such a big move in one day. This was picked up by the traders and flew. So that's why when it reached the second target, I said, peel it off and pull back at that point, and then formed a little bit of a pendant consolidation, broke out, and gave a second leg up to the target for 1945. Big volume into the close. This, I think it's gonna extend. My next target is 2109. This is the third target, but I think we're gonna go see, look at the 10 channel top at 23. We'll see what tomorrow does. Any pullback consolidation, as long as it remains above 18, I think it's entry opportunity. Big volume today. This one not too long ago was up into the 40. So stay tuned, because this thing is a rocket, can fly. Support is, we have tightened the stops now, was 18.50 and then 17.90, remain the same. SRNE is coming off the support, breaking out, volume is good, there was a large intraday volume, sent you a message right there, and then a follow-up, and going into the close, another large volume. Let's see what it does and how far it extends. Trade channel and the ATMA. Above the ATMA is good, below the ATMA is a sell. If it closes below. Targets now 831, 967, and 1111. Support are 7 and 6. Wow. Support 7. Yeah, no, see, no, 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 no. So the support is today low 7:10, 7:20, and then the secondary support is this low 6:50. Let's call it 7:20, 6:50. TNDM in consolidation, the bull deck is going to still bullish. It's 7 struggle breaking out of the 105. If it does, looking for 111 and 119, this will be third and fourth. Support 198. Woozy, this was, remember, was mentioned here, and I think even yesterday. And then today broke out with a massive news that Verizon is adopting their technology for the 5G stuff. It didn't, after the pop in, it didn't produce anything. In fact, it pulled back and retested down to the support at 310, 330. Number volume is huge. So this might be done. We don't know. It might come back down and retest the ATMA 3. Those are all possibilities. But keep an eye on it, because if it is a breakout and the volume, we might get a bigger volume like we did back here, then it could extend. Now, obviously, the news is out, so everybody knows it and everybody's trying to buy it. That's it. But if it extends 5, 6, 10, and 8, 6, 8, 18, for you, if you ended up trading it, the stop was today was 3:20, 3:30. VTRH, finally, this moved a little lower than expected, but it's holding the ATMA. This is an idea. Keep an eye on it, because I still like the technicals and this big volume here. It's interesting. And now fill the gap to this high, 2.44. Today low was 2.44, and today low. No, 308 and 318. So almost fill the gap. There is then this support here at 294. You might have to come down and test it. But moving forward, I'll look for a move above 360, 378. And if you start working, 440, 540, and 688. Looks very interesting. All right, folks, thanks for watching. Good trading. See you tomorrow.